Good morning, everybody. My name is Shinji. I'm a senior lecturer of Library Information Science at University of Japan. She said I will present my talk in Japanese, but in English. Thank you very much for your kind introduction. It's truly an honor for me to have the opportunity to speak with you at European Association of Japanese Specialists with long history. I would like to thank Mr. Van der Weef and Ms. Kreeft for their kind of support to invite me at this conference. To be honest, this is my first, I hope not the last, guest speaker international conference, so I'm extremely nervous to be standing here alone. But anyway, let's get started. Some of you have difficulty to see my slide. You can download my slide at SlideShare. So please Google SlideShare and SMINE. This is the outline of my talk today. First, I will try to explain background information or framework of scientific activities, scholarly communication, and open access. With this background, with this basic understanding, then I will overview our current status of open access in Japan in terms of repositories, journals, policy, and researchers. Finally, I will conclude my talks by prospecting future direction of open access movement in Japan. So, why do scholars conduct research? They are engaged in research to make original contribution to the body of knowledge in the field. To make a research plan, exhaustive literature review of previous studies is essential for focusing research question. Research method needs to be based on the paradigm of in their own field. Then scholar engage in the experiments, observations, and surveys to obtain new research results for answering their research questions. At last, not the least, scholars write and submit their manuscript to scholarly journals. If it is accepted for publication, their research results are integrated as accepted component of scientific knowledge in their field. In scholarly communication, it is extremely important to obtain latest information and publish his or her own research in scholarly journal or books or somewhere. Garvey stated this process of communication as communication is the essence of science. Without scholarly information, we cannot conduct research. Without publishing, scholars cannot be recognized. So scholars give away their research for free. In turn, they can obtain other research. Hagstrom called this scientific norm as a gift exchange. Scholar writes, for example, a scholarly journal for scholarly impact rather than money. Over time, research results need to be communicated in informal and formal scholarly communications, such as informal talks, a meeting, Twitter and SNS and a conference like this, and journals and book. According to Rosenthal, function of scholarly communications are registration, certification, awareness, and archiving. Only scholarly journals integrated these four functions in the system journals. For this reason, among a variety of scholarly information, peer-reviewed scholarly journal have been the key element in the scholarly communication system. According to Professor Stuart Sieber of Harvard University, scholarly communication has four goals listed in the priority from most to least. First and most fundamental goal is sustainability. Scholarly communication system must be financially sound. If the system cannot be sustained, cannot provide and maintain access to scholarship. Second goal is openness. We want widest possible distribution, ideally completely open access, so long as sustainability system can be sustained. Third goal is author's freedom. Each author should be able to choose how to use and communicate his or her own research, though subject to open availability of others to use their research as well. Fourth goal is efficiency. We want scholarly communication system that keep costs low, doesn't waste resources, and use them as efficiently as possible. As said, sustainability is the most important goal in scholarly communication. But as you know, its long-term sustainability questioned. Needless to say, this graph shows library journals' annual average subscription price in each field. And the price has risen significantly faster than library budget and inflation. We are in the price crisis for a scholarly journal. Personally, I strongly hope my university library can successfully renew our big deal contract with a publisher, especially Elsevier in this country. This functional situation in scholarly communication have brought about open access in all over the world. Open access means a free online access to scholarly information. But open access especially focus on peer-reviewed scholarly journal because of as explained before. Convergence of old tradition and new technology have made open access possible. I listed here typical benefits from open access to scholarship. Open access is expected to build better scholarly communications than ever. Like to improve flow of information and to this demonstrate social return of research. So how can we accomplish open access to our research literatures? In this slide, I map a basic concept of open access in terms of vehicles and barriers. As a vehicle or means to make research literature open access, there are two roads, green open access and gold open access. The former is self-archiving in repositories, and the latter is open access journals. This distinction answers how it is delivered. Gratis and libre open access is about user rights or freedom, and answer how open is it? Gratis open access are free of charge and remove pricing barriers. Libre open access is free of charge and also free of some copyright and licensing restrictions. Each stakeholder in a scholarly communication to choose how to accomplish open access to something based on this concept. The volume of peer-reviewed open access article has grown at an increasing rate for more than a decade. According to recent results by Science Metrics in Canada, about half of journal articles are freely available online within a year of publication. As this bar chart shows clearly, there is a disciplinary difference in how open access to articles are accomplished and how many articles are open access. But anyway, half of article of peer reviewed article is open access is a big fact. One of the main drivers of steady growth of open access is adoption of open access policy by government, research funders, and institutions around the world. Since mid 2000s, a growing number of research universities around the world and have adopted open access policy for journals publication of their faculty. So I move to next topic, current status to scholarship in Japan. First, a repositories. At this of months, there are more than 700 institutional repositories in Japan. This steady growth owns to two IRs related program provided by National Institute of Informatics. As you can see, first one is institutional repository program. This program played a distinct role in providing financial support for implementing IR in Japanese universities. Second one is Agile Crowd. As suggested by its name, NRI provides technical and social infrastructure. Each university can easily build their own IR in crowd environment. Today, about half of universities in Japan manage their own IRs. There are 1.5 million full-text deposits in IRs. And it is amazing that 140 million full-text were downloaded in 2013. Japan has now largest or second largest IRs, number of IRs in the world. Of course, this is depend on what's a kind of stats I use here. But anyway, Japan is a big number of IR. Japan has a big number of IRs. So what kind of materials are deposited in Japanese IR? This slide clearly shows the department bulletin in Japanese Kyo account for half of materials. We can say that IR act as an electronic journal platform for Kyo. The number of peer-reviewed journal articles, a primary focus of open access, unfortunately has increased over the time. But it is about 15% of all materials. According to some authority in Japan, it accounts for about 5% of peer-reviewed scholarly journal published by Japanese authors. So next, open access journal. There are no international academic published company in Japan. Development of open access journal is supported by government or public institutions. In Japan, JST, Japan Science and Technology Agency, and JST and NIELS are two major open access platforms. They now provide millions of open access articles. But unfortunately, NIELS will be taken over by JSTHRight because of financial reasons. A recent survey of my colleague in Japan showed embarrassing future of Japanese scholarly journal electronic publishing. As of 2013, only less than half of Japanese scholarly journals were electronic journals. Although almost all scholarly journals in European or US publisher or society are electronic journals. And 20% of Japanese scholarly journals provide open access to articles they publish. I am not sure more and more journal will be digitized and open access because of the weakness of system in journal management of Japanese scholar society or academic societies. So next is policy developments. Japan is not a leading country in the development of open access policy such as UK and USA, but we can see a clear endorsement of for promoting open access or open science by government and research funders and institutions. Here, I will show you recent development of open access policy by these three groups. First, government open access policy. Government open access policy made a giant leap forward in 2013 and this year. Due to the division of degree regulation in 2013, doctoral dissertation must be published not in print, but via the internet. Institutional repository of each degree award institution should be used mainly via the internet. Signing dissertation by NII now provides us federated search of dissertation in Japan. In March of this year, Cabinet Office formed expert panel open science and published final report promoting open science in Japan, opening up a renewed era for the advancement of science. In that report, the core principle of promoting open science in Japan is to enhance utility of public-funded research, including research paper and research data. This policy will direct each ministries to develop their own open access policies for publication and research data. Next, fund our open access policy. JST makes and Japan Science Promotion of Science, a major research funder in Japan. In 2013, JSD has implemented open access policy, but unfortunately, it's not a mandate and recommendation. Granting aid for scientific research, we call it in Japanese kakenhi, is the largest competitive fund covering all fields and play a major role to support all type of research in Japan. Next, JSPS have no formal open access policy yet, such as NIH public access policy or RCUK open access policy in US and UK. But this April, MEC silently expressed a positive stance toward encouragement of open access funded research. As you can see, in order to that, anyone can freely read this scientific paper without charging using the internet. We encourage the open access publication paper that are written by Kakenhi funds. MEX provide very unique funds in the context of open access. Granting aid for publication of scientific research results is a fund for supporting or launching open access journals with a 5-year contract. At the moment, 5 journals receive this fund. So I hope all of them will be successful to build a brand of open access journal. Next, university open access policy. Japanese university also implemented open access policies. Hokkaido University, Okayama University, or NITEC are pioneers of development of open access policy. But unfortunately, their policy are not as strong as that of, for example, Harvard University, MIT. Policy in terms of scope and strongness of policy. But this April, Kyoto University adopted its open access policy. This is the first university-wide open access policy, open access mandate policy in Japan. I think Nishikawa-san of Kyoto University will talk soon later, so I can't wait hearing her this presentation. As far as I know, two other research-intensive national universities will also implement open access policy soon. So 2015 may be a good year for university open access policies. So last is researchers and open access. So how scholars think about or reacted to development of open access movement in Japan? I will show you part of the result of a recent nationwide author survey by Spark Japan, I also engaged in. From this survey, we can see open access has become popular among Japanese scholars, but at the same time, some of them are in confusion. About half of them have ever published in open access journals, such as PROS1 and scientific reports. But unfortunately, some of them are also published in predatory journals. Recently, splashed a severe concern of its integrity. The reason to publish in open access journals reputation of journal in the field, journal scope and readership, and integrity of peer review. So open access itself may not be an important factor in selecting a journal when scholars submit their articles. Here are some of open-ended opinion by Japanese scholars as to open access in general. First two opinions are clearly supportive to open access journal. Needs and importance of open access journal will be increasing. I appreciate major of scholarly journal with open access can be accessed from office or at home. But on the contrary, the last two opinion was extremely negative to open access and open access journals. The wording of the last opinion was personally shocking to me. He or she said open access journals have a harmful influence on society by producing scientific unsound articles. I guess he or she refers to a predatory journal, or he or she pay APC to a predatory journal. I don't know. Or she is angry at open access journals. All in all, we can see a huge gap in Japanese scholars' recognition to open access. The scholars usually have their own culture, so they don't act as a block. I think that's why scholars have different opinion to open access. In summary, we have marked some milestone in the history of open access movement. Our Japanese library community successfully have implemented largest or second largest number of institutional repository in Japan with Hita-Hita approach. Hita-Hita is Japanese. That means to be tenacious, preserving, and to work step by step without giving up. I think that this term represents typical Japanese spirituality very well. Policy development clearly pushed for open access scholarship, and scholars in Japan are embracing open access. So I will conclude my talk by prospecting future direction of open access in Japan. Unfortunately, I am a visionary person, but I will try to show you a future direction of open access in Japan. As you can see, this is a concept map depicted in a report by an expert panel of open science report. In response to a formulation of government open science policy by Cabinet Office, stakeholders in scholarly communications are likely to take a concrete step toward open science. For example, in the forthcoming fifth science and technology basic plan, promoting open science will be stated. Some ministry, for example, MEXT, Monbukagakusho, is in consideration for formulating its open access policy. I personally expect that open access will be mandatory to funded research results such as publication research data. This will bring a huge impact and possibility to all of us here. So at the moment, I strongly hope that the library community in Japan, together with the non-Japanese community, will be able to play a distinct role in building a better scholarly communication than ever. Thank you for your attention, and I'm happy to answer your question as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Mine-sensei. So from the podium, we want to have some questions in Japanese, in English. 英語でも日本語でも結構ですので、日本あの峰先生のご発表に関してのご質問ありましたらぜひお願いいたします。
My name is Ursula Flache of Berlin State Library. Thank you very much for your very informative talk with a lot of figures and graphics, which was very easy to understand and get a picture. When I visited the library fair and forum in Yokohama 2 years ago, there was also a forum about open access institutional repositories in Japan. And there was also the number that there are very a large number of institutional repositories, the second largest number in the whole of the world. However, they said there's not much in them. Has this changed recently? The number of published articles and papers is still very low. And I would like to ask you if you can comment on this contrast between the large number of the existing repositories and the small acceptance of the repositories by the scholars themselves, or is this about to change now? Is my information outdated already? Could you maybe explore a little bit further on this point?
Okay. Thank you for your kind question. I think main reason of a large number of institutional repository is this one. Makes Monbukagakusho's doctoral dissertation open access policy. This is a mandate open access policy, so university have to build their own IRs. And at the same time, NII also provide a crowd environment for university, which does not IRs. So these two conditions will probably lead to a large number of IRs in Japan.
Are you, it's okay for this answer, Ms. Flachman?
Yeah.
Another questions?
May I add some comments for the question?
Yes, of course.
Question? As he mentioned, so the research or institutional repositories were established as a governmental policy and then not supported by researchers. And then, most of Japanese open access journals are in the field of science, technologies, and medicine. Then, so a kind of journals which represent Japanese cultures and not so much published in open access. So far, in total, from NIEAJRS, 191 journals are opened, and then from JSTAGE, 530 journals are published in open access in humanities and the social science field. But major Japanese culture journals are published from publishers which hate digital publishing. Then, unfortunately, so far, for example, Japanese literature or Japanese history journals are not only in open access, but also in digital world. Thank you.
Another questions or comment? じゃあ、私もじゃあ日本語でやりますけど、私自身も、実は同僚から日本でのオープンアクセスのパーセンテージはものすごく高くて世界でも1、2を争うというふうに言われて、私の日常業務の感覚とかなり格差があるので、一体どういうことかなと思った時に、やっぱりオープンアクセスは企業レベルのものが非常に多いということが分かりました。人文学でも企業になると割合と、あるわけですけど、あくまでも企業だと、まあ、学部内のもの、まあ、先生方のものもありますけれども、学生、修士学生の論文、そういうものがメインになります。実際私たちが日本学としての図書館員として仕事をしている場合に、文学ですとか、歴史ですとか、そういうものの、記事を手に入れたいとなると、このご発表の中にもありましたけれども、大体日本の国内の先生方はやはり、もう、地位のある、書店が出している雑誌に、自分たちの、記事を発表されますので、今のご説明にあったように、日本の出版社はそのオープンアクセスの手前のデジタル化のところもまだまだまだまだできていないという状況があって、結局私たちは先生方、学生の希望する記事を手に入れるにあたっては、もしもあれば国立国会図書館を通してプリントされたものを注文することができます。でも国立国会図書館にない場合に、あるいは非常に新しい記事だった場合に、どうやって手に入れるかというと非常に難しくなります。それで例えば個人的にどこかの図書館が持っているということが分かった場合に、そこに連絡を取って、オスロ大学図書館ですけれども、これの記事をいただけませんでしょうかというと、これは新しすぎて図書館としては提供できませんということになります。そうすると利用者に、申し訳ないけれども日本にもし知り合いがいたら個人的にその記事をコピーしてスキャンして個人的に送ってもらうことはできるけども、図書館としてのサービスができませんというのが現状なんですけど、先生これは正しい状況でしょうか。現状でしょうか。
I will answer in Japanese. 研究者としては違法かもしれませんけれども、非常に助かるとは思います。必要な論文とか文献というのが手に入れられないというのは、研究を進める上で非常にフラストレーションになるので、どんな形であれ、入手できるのであれば、それは助かるとは思います。個人的にはやっぱ図書館員の人は非常に真面目なので、そこら辺はあんまりやってくれないなと思います。
ち ちょっと今の件に少し日本語で失礼しますコメントさせていただきたいんですけど、やはりその今その日本のオープンアクセスの議論をしているところとですね、その日本文化の資料を扱うあの人たちのところかなり距離がありまして、結局オープンアクセスといったらその海外の人たちにも見てもらいたい、だから英語で書いてあるものはどんどん発信しようってなるんですが、日本語で書いてあるものを海外に発信してどうするんだというようなですね、あのそうすると日本で買えればいいじゃないかというふうになってしまいがちなんですね。そうするとまあその論文ジャーナル作ってる人たちもそう思ってますし、オープンアクセスやってる人たちもそう思っているので、あの例えばですね、この NCC の方々と時々お話しするんですが、やはりその、海外で日本語の論文誌があのデジタルで読めるようになってほしいと思われている、そしてできればオープンアクセスになってほしいと思っている人たちがたくさんいるんだということをですね、あのヨーロッパからも発信していただけると話がですねすごくやりやすくなると思いますということをですね、あの集まっている皆さんにぜひお願いしたいと思っております。よろしくお願いします。
先生何かコメントありますか、これに関しては。
あの先ほどのご意見は非常に正しいと思いまして、おそらく多くの人は日本語の資料に対する海外からのニーズというものがあるということを知らないと思うんですね。ですので皆さんぜひ日本にプレッシャーをかけてください。今日本の政府はスーパーグローバルとかグローバルなんとかという政策が非常に好きなので、多分お金がたくさんつくかもしれません。
ありがとうございます。どうぞ。
慶応大学の津田真由美です。私は江戸文学のなので、一番こうあまり進んでいない分野、古い、古典文学なので学会に所属していますが、最近どこの学会でもオープンアクセスにするという方向で動いているの で、ただ許諾が取れない、ごめんなさい、日本語で喋ってますけど、許諾が取れない方のものをオープンアクセスにするのが難しいっていうことで、ある程度時代を区切って新しい論文に関してはどんどんこうオープンにしている状態なんですね。まだ進んでないところもあると思うのですけども、なのでもしかすると、大学よりもその発行している例えば近世文学会とか、そういうその専門の学会にお問い合わせになった方がPDF ファイルを入手しやすいかもしれないというふうに思います。
ありがとうございます。いろいろ方法がありそうですけれども、まだそれを取りまとめていただくところが日本にあると海外からアクセスする私たちはありがたいなという感じがします。それから、出版社の方々、あと日本政府は非常にお金を使って日本学の支援をしてくださって、ジャパンファンデーションもしっかりいろんな方、今回おいでいただいている、出版、支援、出版財団の方ですね、日本から発信する情報ということに非常に、この頃目を向けられていますけれども、あと海外でも日本学の人気はまだ落ちていないですね。非常にたくさんの学生が日本語を勉強したい、日本学を勉強したい、いろんな入り口はあるけれども、日本語を読める人の数は海外で非常に増えています。あと日本人であったり日本の研究者の方が一時的に海外に滞在することも増えています。そういうことから考えると、人文学のものであっても日本語のものであっても海外でこのデジタルの時代に日本語の情報が手に入らない、ましてや図書館として研究者や学生をサポートしたいところが合法的にサポートができないという非常に奇妙な現実があるということを、こちらから日本に帰られる方、あるいは日本の方々にもアピールしていただけたらいいなというのが、私の気持ちです。他にございませんか。それでは、峰先生のお話をここで終わりにしたいと思います。ありがとうございました。